Yeah. Brother Carter.
Why is it more than me? Well, I try to be supportive in being a pastor. There's no way you have to go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Choice of career, belief, and feelings in private life, no matter what the situation is. Reported that as we invest, families can afford some loved ones.
Yes.
That might have been it. Thank you, that part. And only if the God of grace and mercy. According to John 14, verse 2 and 2, that
Amen. To this family, to this family, Carl, Anthony, Sonia, Priscilla,
one of the things that he really encouraged me
Yeah. citizen though, you know, I was 13, 14 years old. I'm in dental school. I can do it. So I go, I come to the county. He didn't want to ask me to make a nice score for first base. As soon as I do that, he didn't want to ask me to make a nice score.
Thank you.
I Good evening.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
And it says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in a path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I would like to also take time to read to you 1 John chapter 3, verse 14, where it says, we know that we have passed from death to life. Giving all honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to all the pastors, to the family, to all the friends in New Harold, God bless you. I want to tell the family what an honor it is to bring the word. And I would like to use a thought this morning, change. You see, two strangers, an old man and a teenager, were fishing from the banks of the Mississippi River. Time passed quickly, because though the fish was poor, the conversation was good. And by the time the sun began to sink in the west, they had talked about many things. At dusk, they could see a large when the teenager saw the boat, he began to shout, over here, here I am, come get me. And he was hoping to get the attention of the people on the boat. The old man watched him and then said, son, you're foolish. If you think that boat is going to stop for you, you're crazy. It's on its way to some faraway place, and it sure isn't going to come by here and pick you up. Suddenly, the boat began to slow down and turn toward the riverbank. To the amazement of the old man, the boat came near enough to the shore and lowered the gangplank. The boy, the teenager, got on board. Sir, I'm not foolish. My father is the captain of the boat, and we're going to a new home up the river. Sometimes life is like that. Sometimes God's ship of death makes an unexpected stop along the river life, and to our surprise, he picks up a passenger. The separation may be sudden, but this we can be absolutely sure is our Father is the captain of the boat and is heading for a new home, amen?
Right.
In the first letter of John, we find these precious words. We know that we have passed from death to life. Jesus taught his disciples that this life is eternal, and death is not the end. So John affirms the truth that death is only a door in which we pass through, a door that leads us to our eternal home. We're here today for several reasons. First and foremost, we're gathered together in a common bond with our mutual relationship with Herod. We come to show honor and respect
in the twinkling of an eye. John accepted the promise of the gift of eternal life without any hesitation. There's no use in having advanced details about some place where you're not yet excited to go. That would be like telling a child how wonderful life is going to be when he becomes a man. The pleasure of added experience escapes him, and the great responsibility of supporting a family and working in the community would probably bring tears to his eyes. Likewise, we cannot comprehend how leaving our loved ones, and that it's familiar to us, could possibly be any joy. You could not understand the pleasure of sitting at the right hand of the Father in heaven, would you leave right now? If we could open up to heaven and peek through it right now, it would probably startle us. The holiness of heaven would cause many people to run and hide because we have not yet been changed. Prematurely sending someone to heaven is like trying to find a square peg and put it in a round hole. Heaven will never be a good fit until the Father sends for us. We must be changed. Our limited understanding does not mean that heaven is not a reality, nor does it mean that we should not desire a heavenly home someday. We only have the one thing to understand that Harold understood, that death does not cause our change. Jesus Christ is the one that changes us. And the timing of our transition from this life to eternal life is Jesus Christ and Christ alone. Jesus changed Harold. Jesus made all the preparations necessary for Harold to afford the old ship of Zion. Jesus changed Harold at a very young age, and he came out with a lot of love. Harold loved the community of Chanute and the people in Chanute, and he touched a whole lot of people in Chanute. And if you don't
just ask, no.
He said, hang on. Just wait a minute. We're going to have to move all of you down to San Jose Park. You kids are getting too big. You're getting too strong. I'm having to place the windows at y'all. Keep breaking out. So they moved into San Jose Park. Harold, we're ready. And thus we do not fear death. And thus